Open Suctioning of an Endotracheal Tube by Mary-Jeanne Manning. This video demonstrates suctioning of an indwelling endotracheal tube. Special considerations that apply to certain populations, such as premature infants and some infants with congenital heart disease, will not be discussed in this video.
As I get ready, I'm going to have my colleague come and start to hyperoxygenate the patient. She'll disconnect from the ventilator and cover or cap the ventilation system in order to maintain its cleanliness. And then she'll provide 100% oxygen to the patient by giving breaths through the bag mask system.
Point of clarification.
Hyperoxygenation. Hyperoxygenation refers to the process of providing 100% oxygen to your patient for several minutes prior to performing a procedure, such as intubation or endotracheal tube suctioning. The purpose of hyperoxygenation is to denitrogenate the patient's lungs to achieve a higher percentage of oxygen. This provides some reserve and prevents desaturation events while disconnecting the patient from the ventilator in order to perform endotracheal tube suctioning.
At this point, we can actually notice or observe presence or absence of secretions in the tube, and we can determine any difficulty with bagging the patient. I'm going to maintain one sterile hand and use this hand as my dirty hand to connect my suction. And we also would observe our oxygen saturation and other vital signs to make sure that we're stable prior to starting the procedure. And then I'll ask my colleague to disconnect. I'll note the markings on my tube and start to pass, not applying any suction while I'm passing the tube. I will line up the numbers and go past, start to apply suction, and using a pill rolling technique, remove the tube. I do not want to apply suction for any more than 10 seconds at a time.
Point of clarification.
Pill rolling technique. Pill rolling technique refers to the process of placing the suction catheter between your finger and thumb and moving your thumb and finger in opposite directions over and under the catheter to cause the catheter to swivel in a circular motion inside of the endotracheal tube as you withdraw it from the patient.
In between passes, we'll also continue to hyperoxygenate and watch our oxygen saturation and make sure they're either remaining at baseline or come back to baseline prior to passing the catheter again. And we'll pass it one more time to make sure we've rid the tube of any secretions. And I line up, make sure I go to the proper depth, apply suction, and remove. You want to note the amount of secretions that you've suctioned, any the color, consistency, and any odor that you might have. Also, it's not recommended for routine suctioning, but if you note that the secretions are particularly thick, you may want to instill saline down the tube and then bag the saline in order to loosen up those secretions.